If there's one strand of consistency across all corners of this country, it's the undeniable fact that a majority of children have experienced academic regression. The amount of information lost ranges and is determined based on many different factors. Any learning challenges that exist. Number two, your child's ability to handle change, or their comfort level when it comes to independent study. Number four, your child's willingness to push through challenges, their ability to organize work and ability to prioritize work. Number seven, their openness to proactively seeking help and their willingness to gain assistance from parents. Also, the structure of the virtual classroom. How many kids are in the class? Are they able to get any individualized assistance? Number 10 is the ease of systems, aka how many systems your child's school makes them use for daily work. I struggle greatly trying to figure out where everything is within the myriad of tools the school system has my third grade daughter using, along with countless other factors. The bottom line is that there really aren't very many children throughout the U.S. that have not been affected by the ping-ponging of schools over the last 9 to 10 months. Of the hundreds of parents I've had a conversation with over the past few months, a vast majority described their child's number one challenge is simply organizing their schoolwork independently. Working from a virtual schooling platform, children are required to keep track of assignments and forced to work through them with little to no help. In a traditional classroom, teachers and aides are able to wander around the room and help children with quick questions, which help ensure they remain on task. These small bumps along the journey of learning are quickly patched and progress continues forward. Second would be the inability to ask specific questions when challenges arise. The lack of support in this area leads many children to frustration and ultimately shutting down. A large portion of parents report trying to help, but often their child sees them as mom and dad, not teacher, and they aren't really open to the support. That's exactly what we see daily in our house. Many parents report struggling to reach their child in the way they understand it best. So the information never gets passed to them, which leads to frustration, stress, and some strained relationships. So what is the answer in all of this? One-on-one virtual tutoring. Because children who are quickly becoming burnt out from endless difficult work aren't looking to add additional math programs. They just don't want to spend 4 hours on a 20-minute assignment. They don't want to feel like they're never able to get caught up. And all they get to hear from mom and dad is, do your work, or stay in there until your homework is done, or why didn't you finish the assignment today? They just want to be kids and have some type of a normal, fun life. But how do you know what type of tutoring is best for your child? Well, today we cover just that. Welcome to this episode of Special Education Parenting Tips. Daily, I have conversations with parents who are desperately seeking someone to help their child break through the academic barrier so frequently found with large group virtual classroom environments. During my conversations, I'm often asked, what is the difference between the individualized nature of special education tutoring and the classical form of tutoring? For the purpose of this video, I'm going to cover two different services today. First, traditional virtual tutoring, and second, special education virtual tutoring. Now, there are thousands of canned programs out there. These are programs that have a defined syllabus or an outline presented to you before talking with anyone. They're mainly designed to help children who are behind in a subject get caught back up through supplemental learning. Another way of saying this is adding more work to their week that's based on where your child is academically, not according to their age. All right, back to tutoring. First, let's cover the primary definition of these services, starting with traditional virtual tutoring. Traditional virtual tutoring is primarily used in an as-needed approach. In other words, children connect with an educator if they are struggling through an assignment or a particular lesson or even trying to study for an upcoming test. In this model, there's often very little relationship building that takes place, as an educator may only see that particular child a few times a month. Neurotypical children or those that do fine in day-to-day school without the need of specialized instruction most often work just fine with this level of instruction. You'll often see young adults in college conducting this type of assistance as a way to earn a little income and make a positive impact in the lives of children who struggle from time to time. Special education virtual tutoring is about relationships. It's not a one-size-fits-all approach and is designed to be a longer-term, individualized program. The special educators we have on our team are all currently full-time teachers or have been classroom teachers in the past, which means they have experience working with children who learn differently and require a higher level of individualized instruction. Next, let's cover the reasons for choosing a traditional virtual tutor versus a special education virtual tutor. First, the reasons for choosing a virtual tutor for your child. Difficulty studying for an upcoming test, or your child has difficulty in a particular lesson or assignment. Your child may have a challenge understanding a specific concept or strategy. Now, math is the easiest to visualize. That subject can get very complex. Or new struggles arise, which is not linked to anything in past years. An example is if your child has always been in a regular-sized classroom and breezed through pre-algebra, but due to the inability to ask questions in a virtual environment, Algebra 1 has become increasingly difficult. Another example is if your child's grade dropped in a specific subject this year, but you've never seen that before. Next, let's cover the reasons a special education virtual tutor would make sense for your child. Number one, the academic struggle has been going on for a while. Number two, your child is behind grade level wise in a certain subject or subjects. Your child has difficulty sitting still for virtual lessons. This is the piece we've perfected over the years. Number four, your child has a learning challenge and the services they are supposed to receive in schools are not being honored while learning is virtual. And number five, you've tried everything and nothing seems to help. Your child is not connecting in the way you try to teach them. As a result, you and your child become frustrated and stressed every time you try to help. Number seven, your child has a challenge organizing their day and work, so assignments are falling through the cracks, left and right. I truly could go on and on, but I think you get the idea. We've been working online specifically with children who have attention challenges and children with learning challenges for over 6.5 years now. We have a massive team of highly qualified special educators who are experts in helping children where they are and in the way they understand best. Our first step is an individualized, no obligation, free consultation to discuss the specifics regarding your child's challenges, strengths, educational background, and their likes. This is because we customize all aspects of what we do to your child. From there, we begin by creating an individualized learning experience for your child. The cost is minimal, about the same as a family trip for ice cream. However, the result is a program that's 100% unique to your child, conducted in the way they learn, and paced at the level they are comfortable with. If your child is in a place where traditional virtual tutoring would work for their needs, there are many organizations out there who can help. However, if you found that your child's needs go beyond occasional assistance, and perhaps there are some missing foundational pieces in their education, take the first step and sign up for a free consultation right now. There's a link in the upper right-hand corner of this video, along with one in the description. The call is usually less than 30 minutes, but every single question you have will be answered and a specific path for your child will be visible. If you have any questions whatsoever, please leave a comment or contact us directly at the phone number displayed on the screen. The bottom line is that you and your child will get through this. Just keep going. From all of us at specialedresource.com, thank you for watching this episode of Special Education Parenting Tips. We'll catch you in the next video. Thank you for watching this video until the end. Please take a moment, give us a thumbs up. Your support means the world to us. If there's a specific topic you're interested in, please leave a comment. Until then, enjoy these other videos designed to help parents navigate the crazy world of special education. Thank you.